Well, Registrar Andi Matheu has to be happy about her new digs in a beautiful building, really. It's been renovated by the parish, a couple of blocks from the courthouse, and a lot more room. And those of us who like to early vote will really enjoy it.
Yes, we are thrilled with all the extra room. I'm anxious to see how it works this fall with a big election coming up, but I think it's going to be great. We've got a really good flow to the building, and we have everything we need in one spot. It's nice.
Well, the parking, there'll be no comparison, but what about the square footage of the building itself? How does it compare to where you were before?
I'd say we have four times the space we had in the other office, all in all, even with our storage upstairs.
The way the popularity of early voting has really taken off, you have to wonder. I mean, I don't think it'll be too much.
Oh, no. I think we'll probably have to reconfigure for the presidential, but this fall being a big, busy election, it'll be a good tipping point to see which way we need to do it.
Of course, a big fall ballot here in Tangipahoa and statewide, in fact, but nothing compares to next year in the presidential race.
No, it's going to be a bear, but I think we're ready for it.
So typically, what happens in preparation for such a big election? Are people aware they need to watch their registration and make sure it's up to date?
I would like to think that they are, but we learn every day that nobody, either they're not aware that they need to change their registration address with us if they move. We do our annual canvass every summer. So if anyone does a change of address or a forwarded address, we will get that information during the summer. But if you move and don't tell me you move, then you could be registered at your original address forever because I have no other reason to know you moved.
How often do people get taken off the rolls?
People will be marked as inactive, and we'll do that once we receive mail back from them once or twice. We'll mark them as inactive. All that means is when you come in to vote, you're required to fill out an address confirmation card prior to voting. To be removed from the rolls, you have to be inactive and not vote in two federal elections. So that's 4 years being inactive with no activity on your record. Most people have some activity every 4 years.
So now that you're moved in, what's going to happen next? I mean, I imagine just getting everything set up is going to take a while.
I rearrange a room every time I walk into it. That will probably happen for the next couple of months, but we did get all of our election supplies, our envelopes, so we'll start labeling all of that, making our bundles for our mail ballots, and we'll start prepping in the next month or so.
So is it fair to say that all the services available here in Amite are also available at your office in Hammond on Club Deluxe Road?
Absolutely. Our Hammond office and our Amite office are both fully functional. You can do everything here that you can do there. The only difference is now this one in Amite's a little newer and fresher, but Hammond got a facelift 2 years ago. So I'm proud of where we are right now.
What else do you want to share with us?
Go vote.
And most people don't.
Registering is only half the battle. You have to get out and go vote.